anybody need an extra copy of the minutes or the agenda? Not on, great. Good. All right, there is no one present from the public or public comment. So we can move right into the notes from the February meeting. Did you have a chance to review them? Thank you. Welcome for sending them.
I did. I move that we approve the minutes.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Great. Great. I know that some of us were at the March for Our Lives Northampton event this weekend. I saw Davina there in her Human Rights Commission t-shirt.
Oh, good for her.
Great, totally representing.
Did you?
Or your comic t-shirt? But I was there.
I was there. I didn't have a t-shirt either.
Yeah, and I didn't see you.
It was a little cold.
Yeah, it was.
But I could not get over the crowd.
Yeah.
And I was really, really surprised that the Republican, all they talked about was the Springfield one, which, okay, but I mean, I think the fact that Neil and Warren were there probably was it, but I mean, from what I understand, the crowd was like a third of what it was up here.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, if that. I mean, somebody had said that there were less than 1,000 people. And from here, I've heard around 3, at least. It was a bigger crowd than I've ever seen for a march.
I thought it was the best organized rally I think I've ever been to.
Yeah.
It really
was good.
I agree. You did not stand a job. Were you there?
No. I was towing the horse.
Somebody had
to tow the horse. Don't put that in the minutes.
Yeah.
I really like just the overall, I like the way the young people are pulling together different movements and building on the work of Black Lives Matter.
I just thought it was great. It was just really run by the young people too. I just thought every single speaker and everything were the young people, which I thought was really good.
I'm sorry.
You're only late by a tiny bit. You just happen to start on time. Yeah, I thought they did an outstanding job. If I want to ask if we wanted to send a collective note to the organizers, to the youth organizers of Northampton High School, thanking them for doing that.
Yeah, that would be great.
Is there a specific?
There was a planning committee.
Okay, yeah, I think that'd be wonderful. Yeah.
I have Human Rights Commission postcards.
Oh, that's great.
Postcards?
Ah, that's fantastic.
So, why don't we go to the note card? And I'll pass it around and everybody can sign it. Just leave some space in the middle for a message. Or somebody, if you want to write a message, my writer over there.
Oh, I can't. I don't have any kind of handwriting. I'm going to be coding.
Yeah, I'll put in a message from Ultra House.
Do you want to say anything about the march? We were just
I don't know who else was there. I'm sorry, I have to go through.
We were there.
You were there.
No. The only thing I would say is most people I've ever seen in Northampton, having been to many of different kinds, it was so exciting and such energy, and different from the people who, different from the usual suspects who,
Yes.
I thought it was wonderful.
Yeah.
It seemed like it was replicated around the country. I mean, it just was wonderful.
I wish people didn't get into that social media war with that business owner, though. That's unfortunate.
With what?
With the business owner.
Oh, here in Northampton?
Yeah, there's some cars got towed because they were parked in a private lot. And the people are blaming the owner of the business. And
I read something about that, but I didn't know the story behind it. I just heard that people were upset that their cars got towed.
Yeah, I mean, they were in a private lot, and he uses it for his business, and so he had them towed. But people kind of immediately thought it was because he was against the march, which he says he wasn't. And they're putting bad reviews.
It was unfortunate because from what I could see, some of the lot was across the road, so you might not have known that it was his, from what
which,
I could see on the
which one, road. Which business was the lot?
It's that one at the bottom of the hill, I think it's called Grand.
It's right across the street from the high school parking lot.
Down at the bottom. Yeah, that was unfortunate.
I mean, he was called because some cab company that uses his lot couldn't get their cars up, so he called the police and said, what should I do? And he said,
nothing's ever perfect. But I thought they did a great job with the organizing. And Neural was there, and she made flyers with which she was going to bring tonight for some things you could do next. Here's your legislators' phone numbers, here's how to register to vote, and there's an opening on the Human Rights Commission. So she did have those printed, and she did hand a bunch out. So.
Wow, that's great. That was very,
good idea.
Yeah. So that happened.
So she handed out postcards.
They were full page flyers.
Okay, flyers with information about. Mm-hmm. About how to reach your elected representative and that we have an opening?
Yes.
Great.
Yeah. She did send me an electronic copy. I'll share with you if she doesn't end up being here tonight. Great. Booker, do you have an update on
sure.
conversations?
The final comment is, the more the Human Rights Commission is involved, the better people will like it.
Wait, so say that again?
The end comment is, people would like the Human Rights Commission to be involved with it. So
can you say the date again so I can put it in there?
So on Tuesday, let me be more honest. Tuesday, April 3rd at, there's going to be Northampton Connects. This is a project that was started by a few people who were concerned about the tenor of how debate is done at city council meetings and things close to the city council meetings. And they would like to have better ways of being able to talk about the issues that deal specifically with downtown Northampton. And they thought that they would start using the model of what was done with Leverett and people coming from Kentucky and learning how to talk about difference or different ideas and really learning how to listen. So the first session will be this Tuesday, next Tuesday evening. I'm on the panel, quote, because I'm a member of the Human Rights Commission. And frankly, I was approached after we did our civility kickoff in front of City Hall. I'm trying to find the and I could send you other stuff that if you would like to attach it to the notes.
Is Paula Green going to be the facilitator?
So, let me read a little bit.
Okay.
Northampton Connects is a project initiated by a group of Northampton residents seeking to provide a forum to encourage community conversations, listening, mutual understanding, and exploration of common ground among Northampton residents with varied experiences and points of view. Panelists will include Peter Ives, Booker Bush, Pastor Steph Smith of Cathedral in the Night, John Goldman, a Brandeis student, the youngest Democratic State Committee member and co-founder of the Right to Immigration Institute. He also is a graduate of Northampton High School. Rabbi Justin David of B'nai Israel, Nancy Cohen, owner of Happy Valley Gifts, Judy Harrell, owner of Harrell's Ice Cream. The discussion will be facilitated by Paula Green from Leverett, founder of the Karuna Center for Peace Building. After introductory remarks, Paula will facilitate a 45-minute discussion using techniques she has used to encourage civil conversation in post-conflict and polarized societies. I'm going to skip some paragraph. Northampton Connects has its origins in an October community meeting hosted by Ward 2 City Councilor Dennis Bidwell. And I'll say that he's actually been the real organizer around this activity. The meeting was dominated by a discussion of the polarized nature of the city's debate about proposal for additional municipal surveillance cameras in downtown Northampton.
Did you say the date of that meeting or not?
For which meeting?
The origins from the community.
It's October of 2017.
Okay.
That's the end of sort of this release that Dennis has sent out. And they've set up posters. There's a Facebook page called Northampton Connects. Do you have questions so far, or I can tell you more? So what they're hoping will occur is that there'll sort of be this panel, and this panel will only go for 30 or 40 minutes. We're going to have two questions to talk about. There's still some argument about the questions, what the questions will be. And then we're hoping that after that, people will be able to sit around another, eight people can sit around eight other tables and then sort of have their own discussions similar to what happened before.
And where will this be?
So it's going to be at the JFK Middle School.
In the cafeteria?
I'm not sure. It's going to be in there,
okay.
But it's going to be there
Tuesday,
the 3rd at set from 7 to 9 p.m. By the way, Paula Green is bringing a number of facilitators, so there will be one for each table. So this will be now. So the backstory is, as soon as this was put up on page, people immediately went. There was a very uncivil social media discussion about the fact that it was a JFK rather than in downtown Northampton. And you know, where we had it there because we really didn't want downtown people to be able to get there. So it sort of hit the ground at a really uncomfortable place. And which led us to having some more discussions about what we'll do. We were already hearing that people would be coming to picket and demonstrate at whatever happens. But Paul, you know, so we're talking about how we will try to work with that. But those are the kinds of things we're already anticipating.
That's great.
Well,
I have a thought. I wonder about bringing the pledge, since we haven't wrapped it up yet. We can bring pledge sheets and get people to sign.
People would like that, because that's why I'm sort of trying to learn how to be civil. Still talk about things that there are different opinions about, but still be how to be civil about it.
So do others think that's a good idea?
Yes.
Do we know what people are going to picket regardless of what happens, or picket it being there, or?
The initial things on the social media page were about why wasn't it happening at a venue downtown, and that this was a way to try to not let homeless people or others who live on the streets of Northampton be able to get there, though, frankly, it's pretty easy to get to JFK, and frankly, more of the lower SES people are in Florence rather than sort of around Northampton. So anyway, their, the new website says, by the way, if anybody needs a ride, members of the panel would be glad to give you rides. We'll do whatever we can to make this easy to occur. I don't actually know what people, everybody's assuming this is somewhat about surveillance, somewhat about how will homeless be treated. Is this all the business community trying to get rid of uncomfortable people in the downtown? So there, those are all, and by the way, these are all things that everybody agrees we need to talk about.
The whole point of it.
It's the point.
Yeah.
It's the point. And it's not, we're going to talk about, it's like trying to understand what's going on.
These aren't necessarily my views, it's just what, I'm not saying what I think, it's just what I've heard other people say. I know one of the complaints was the time that it was held at, because homeless people wouldn't be able to attend regardless, otherwise they'd have to give up being in shelter for the night, because the doors lock at a certain time, so even getting rides, I mean, that from some people that was a concern. I also heard, again, not like my personal opinion, but I think because Dennis Bidwell was like the person who began it, people had a lot of frustrations around that, and they felt like somebody who was so polarized or had like a certain opinion when it came to homeless people is the one who kind of had this committee structure to happen. So people felt like that wasn't really an unbiased person to be leading the charge, and then that caused people to not want to attend or to feel like they wanted to protest it. That's what I've heard anyway.
Well, it is a, it's a, it's a catch-22. Because, I mean, you have it during the day and people work. The ones who want to go then, they're working. You know, I mean, I can certainly think that's, you know, somewhat of a valid point for a homeless person if, yes, you know, you can't, you got to be at a shelter. But I'm not sure there's an easy answer to if you're going to have it from after hours or in the evening. But if you have it from 10 to 2, during the day, I think you're going to run into the same challenges.
I think these are the stats floated around in that planning room, and people are saying, look, we are hoping that this will not be the only session, that this is the beginning. And the next session, I think everybody's hoping would actually be at the senior center.
Yeah, that's what I would, what about the possibility down the road of having it on a weekend?
Well, I think people were first talking about who can get there at what time, but you know, that, I guess that's also a possibility.
Yeah, I mean, if you had it from 2 to 4 on a weekend.
I think we have to see what happens.
You know, then yeah, that might be at least closer to that one problem.
I mean, the hope is that this is the first of a number of events.
Yeah.
And as a group, no matter what we did, there was a negative, there was a, another view of it than what it meant. So, it's hard. We've been, so the special thing about being in the meetings is listening to people from the business community in the room talking about their own personal feelings with homeless people and what they do to try to work with people, and they're like amazing stories. Along with, and we're particularly happy that two people were willing to be on this panel, because both of them know that if they are heard to say certain things, people will say, you know, exactly what's happened to the auto mechanic place. So it'll be interesting.
So you ended asking for
a
motion to adjourn?
Well, I'm hoping many of you can be there. And I think if there's a presence from the Human Rights Commission, people would appreciate that.
I can be there.
Yeah, I'm certainly.
See, we're all hoping, we're hoping that 100 people will be there. We're actually in trouble if 200 people are there.
Mm-hmm.
That's sort of the nature of the event. So we'll see what happens.
Should we see who can go from us?
It's Tuesday, April 3rd, 7 to 9 p.m. It's in the community room at JFK. It's not a cafeteria.
They have a class that
maybe
7 to 9.
Okay. I can't remember. It's the
community. I have conflict, but I could try and see if I can get out of it.
It's my dad's birthday.
Oh. tell you what I think is a bad.
I think I should be able to, yeah. I think that should work for me.
I hope you can, we'll certainly have a debriefing.
Yes.
Did you say the big poster? You want to bring the big poster, Karen?
Yeah.
Okay, so are you going to get it, Booker?
Well, one of the, that's another issue for tonight, is seeing if someone can go to Forbes Library and pick up the big poster and the pledge forms there.
I can do that. Oh, you can do that?
Yeah.
Great. Great.
And then should I just bring that to the meeting?
Yes, that would be perfect, thank you.
So you, will you also get the pledge forms? Because we were gonna start collecting.
Sure. I have a few from the schools as well, so.
Yeah, I have an envelope form from the schools.
Awesome.
So is that it for presentation? Thank you, Booker. Since you're here, Earl, would you mind sending those big posters?
Sure. The border got cut off on this set, which is why I had a few extras, but this is just what I handed out at the march.
Such a good idea.
Oh, so they're so good.
These are wonderful. I like the URL code thing. That's great.
Oh, this is really great. Can we have a stack of these for Tuesday night?
Yeah, definitely.
The one thing to.
Yes, any edits or anything?
Yeah, the email address is northamptonma.gov.
Does it have a bottom?
Oh, Emma, thank you.
Yeah, that's good to know. I hope nobody tried to email me.
And I love that you made it to me, URL for the application.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, down.
It's my green purple.
There it is, yep, sorry.
I think that's great.
Thank you.
This is just wonderful.
Thank you.
Yeah. Did you design these yourself?
Yeah.
Skills.
Thank you. I minor in communication, so I need a little.
Oh, fantastic.
Little here and there, yeah.
And the other thing that you missed is we're sending a card to the organizers of the march in Northampton, the rally. Yeah, so. Were you there? Yes, you were there.
Yeah.
Okay, an update on the bystander training that Quabbin Mediation does. So I contacted them to see, I was particularly interested in whether we could host a training of trainers, because I think that would have a greater impact, because we could train people in various communities in Northampton to broaden the reach and just hold in one bystander training. Found out that there is a bystander training happening in Northampton at the JFK Middle School on April 24th. And it's a 2-hour workshop. And what the folks told me was that a prerequisite for the training for trainers is that you attend a bystander training. So the 2-hour training is like one of them. So my question is if there are members of this commission who would like to be trained to be trainers, and then we could then unroll the program after that. Mm-hmm.
At what time is it on the 24th?
It is
6:30 to 8:30.
Yes, 6:30.
I'm going to that. I've already registered.
Okay.
So, and I think it'd be great to have training for trainers.
And that's at JFK?
Yes.
Yes.
Popular place.
It is. You do need to register.
It's an easy place because there's parking.
Yes.
So when you have a lot of people, that's a problem downtown. Also, it's hard to find a place that doesn't cost a bit downtown. Okay.
And if we want him to do
if you want to do this, the April 4th training, you can go to their website.
Also, I sent you a link, and you could send that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can do that.
I could send the link, yeah. Yep. And I think it's $15.
I thought it was free.
Oh, is it?
Well, okay, didn't ask for any money, signed me up.
Yeah, one of their trainings. Okay, and of course, that would give us some insight into what the training is, and whether we think it would be a good idea to train trainers.
Is this being done by the same group?
It's from Quavon Mediation, but they are, I forget what local Northampton.
It's the Northampton Prevention Coalition.
Is bringing it.
So you will send that link, so if we want to register, we can?
Yes.
Okay, great, thank you.
Apparently, Cooley Dickinson's paying for the trainer's fees.
Oh.
Jessica sent me this stuff, so she didn't talk to her at the church.
I didn't talk to her, no.
The RE director at the union is helping us.
Thanks for looking into that. Thanks for looking into that.
Oh, of course.
Did they tell you how long the training for trainers is?
It's a day-long thing, like a 9 to 3 or something like that.
And do they have like a cap of how many people go to it?
Yes, I think I'll have to look back. I think she said 20. Maybe in a different email, but I didn't print out. Yeah. But I thought maybe we could identify some folks in the community who we could. Some of the youth commission or youth organizers of the march. Maybe some of the non-English people from the world would be also good. But we can look at that. One of the things that happened at the march or the rally on Saturday is I was approached by someone asking about whether the Human Rights Commission was going to have any response to the proposed PBTA fare and route changes. And so I said I would bring it up to the committee. If you had a chance to look at those links, the fare has gone up, I think, by 35 cents. Each way, and the route that they're eliminating in Northampton is the one that goes from the senior center to Jackson Street School, which gives access to the survival center on that route as well.
So that's weird because they just got that route going. Mm-hmm. I do think there are human rights implications to reducing, you know, the ability to take bus, public transportation, especially to go to survival center. I did read the articles, but it doesn't really say why they're reducing, I know they have a budget problem, but they didn't say how they chose what routes to reduce and what routes to eliminate, so I don't know if they're eliminating that one because it isn't used. Do you know?
I don't know. I did have a conversation with Heidi from the Survival Center and a different topic, but she did say that it was never as heavily used as they hoped it would be. Maybe several people, but not as many as they hoped used to.
I thought I read a line in the article too that said it was the underused routes were the ones that they were. But I think in the article it said something like that. At like times that people won't travel as much and the routes that people won't travel as much.
It's so complicated because I remember this has happened before at times, the PBTA got things back, it's definitely happened before. And and it affects the people who do take it, just because there's not a lot of people. What do you think?
Exactly.
It's like,
that's still eight people that have to figure out a little bit.
Yeah.
So if we were going to do something, who would we announce? So my understanding is the reason this is happening is because the state has come cut back funding to the BVTA. It's actually not sort of a local issue. It's because the state has dropped funding back. It sits within a this is the way I read it. And also there's not been a fair increase for like 10 years. But there is a big recognition that the only people, that this, the PVTA is pretty much all students and people who are either impoverished or very close to it. So it is a human rights issue in that this is the only way for people with little money to get around. I've got this weird, I've got to say, I find it weird that students don't have to pay something to take it, and that would be a way of defraying a cost. So, but without getting into why that is, or that that might be a more complicated issue. So, from my reading, this is not a state or local issue, it's a going to the state and saying we need more funding for the PVTA for this reason. And that's the way I read this stuff. So if we wrote a letter to the Gazette, I'm not sure what that does, or writing a letter to the city council, it's actually a state funding issue.
So the question is there a role for us to do that kind of advocacy on the state level? It brings us outside the boundaries of Northampton.
I mean, but is there any group in Northampton that's actually reaching out to the state in that sense that we can support?
That's a really good question.
I mean, even if you had a letter to the Gazette or something explaining exactly what you did, what you're saying, this is a state issue, and we are urging the state to help because it affects locally and our residents.
I mean, there's also just the mayor is the chair of the advisory board. I mean, I feel like we can encourage him to fight as hard as he can to not cut the things that help the people who need it the most, not cut the roots.
I don't think that he has any, that role doesn't give him any authority over how much money they get allocated.
Right, but they could, you know, fight with the governor. It's hard to know what to say because I don't know how much the route is, that particular route is used. So.
Well, I guess for Northampton, it's that route, though it's actually a bigger issue. I mean, if they kept that route, then but still cut everything back. Other things might happen, so.
Mm-hmm. It's a
regional issue.
Right, so folks from here need to get over to Target. It will be cut back, at least during some slower times.
My impression from the articles that I read, you know, I've read the three articles, is that people were addressing the state, although it's not clear whether what good it's going to do.
I mean, it's not just a human rights issue, it's also like an environmental issue, and, you know, like, we should be encouraging public transportation use, but that's not, you know, really good, but.
I don't know, my thought is that even if it's a state issue, we should do something because it affects Northampton and it affects our residents. So even if we send, you know, even if we encourage our residents to
it's something that we should, you know, we should take a stand on. And if it means we send something to the state via the Gazette or something, let the people, a letter to the editor, mm-hmm. that know that we are, you know, we're sending a letter to the state or head of that, and we encourage them to, or something like that. I don't know, but I certainly think we should do something.
We could reach out to Elisa and find out if the city council is doing anything, and if they are, can we join them?
Yeah, that's a good point.
It's funny because last time we met, remember they were having that meeting?
Yes.
Because we were meeting up there and somebody came into that room.
Yep.
So they were having a... But I don't remember seeing a story that talked about what people said at those hearings.
It sounds like the five colleges have written.
Yeah.
But it doesn't sound like anyone that we have.
Yeah, they did write a really good letter.
Yeah.
I mean, there is a story, the backstory to why the students write for free. went back to the creation of the Five College Consortium, and it was a deal that was made to make it possible for students to take
classes at other places.
Yeah,
did
and school, I think the college...
Do schools contribute to?
Yeah, I think they do.
House Speaker, Senate Ways and Means Committee Chair, and House Ways and Means Committee Chair.
I mean, there's nothing in our organizational that body or whatever that says we can't write a letter just because it's out of Northampton. I mean, I feel like...
No, I mean, in fact, even this is telling people.
Yeah.
You know, we're encouraging people to go to the assault ban, you know, or whatever. So I think if it affects our community, we go to whoever is responsible for it. So I don't think that's a problem at all.
So then it could be a letter to Charlie Baker and who else was it?
This was sent to, yes, to Leo, Senate President Harriet Chandler, House Speaker Robert Leo, Senate Ways and Means Committee Chairwoman Karen Spilker, House Ways and Means Committee Chairman Jeffrey Sanchez.
And our state representatives.
And our state representatives.
Yeah. Starts. That's, you know, when's the effective date of this? Is it fiscal?
Well, or when they're going to make their decisions, so we know.
Yeah, both, yeah.
Yeah. But also, like, I just kind of feel like I wish I knew what kind of, the whole thing about the use, who uses mm-hmm. it, and how many people use it.
It's a bigger issue, frankly, for my practice in Springfield. This is a huge issue.
Oh, yeah.
That's the way all of my patients get.
So you mean the cutting back of the services?
Yeah. So I mean it's outside of North Springfield, but it's all PDTA.
But so you're saying we know that people are going to be impacted by it?
No, down in Springfield, Hammond County is much is really really big in the city of Springfield.
You mean the use?
The use
and the cutting back.
Oh really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't realize.
There are a lot of lower income people that literally, that's how they get to work. They're living hand to mouth.
It's how they get to my office for care.
Well, for my office, previously incarcerated and they're reentering the community, they use it to be able to go to their programs and stuff, and without that, they'll be more likely to not attend programs and then reoffend and have other, you know, so it's a way for them to get out of the community and do what they need to do instead of being with the people who they were surrounded with beforehand. So it'll definitely impact that, yeah.
Well, it just seems like we shouldn't be among the people that are saying this isn't right.
Would anybody like to, I don't want to assume, would anybody like to take the leadership on finding the answers to these questions and bring the proposal back to the next meeting?
The question in terms of when this decision is being made. What called PVPA? I can't think of what else.
Yeah. So I missed David and Dr. Our mayor is the chair of the advisory committee. Mm-hmm.
But there were a few other things we wanted to know too. Like basically, what's the gist of how they
made the decision?
Yeah. I mean, it's just hard to know what to specifically say to them if we don't know how they decided. And if they decided because nobody uses it, I don't know how we argued that. But
again, there's the cutbacks on top of the, or separate from the elimination.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
I felt just reading through, without knowing the bus routes well yourself, I mean, I know the one in town where it goes and everything, but without being a regular rider, you don't know. I mean, there must be research, I'm assuming, but it's hard to know. I remember when this happened before, it was a huge outcry a few years ago. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It says here that they're requesting public comments by March 14th. And then they had hearings. The last hearing was in Chicopee, March 12th. Hmm. Northampton was February 28th.
Yeah.
We were just, our meeting was displaced.
Yeah. So we are late to this. Mm-hmm. So we really can't wait till the next meeting.
I mean, it seems to me that our sort of primary role is to draw to, as the Human Rights Commission, is to say this disproportionately affects certain groups in the community. And this is, you know, not fair.
Yeah,
not right.
Right.
I mean, that's all I want to say.
Yeah. It would go into effect July 1st.
Well, I think you're right. I think the key is we should just get a message out there that regardless, the situation as it stands now is detrimental to those who need it the most. You know, voice our opposition.
Do we do it to all the 24 buildings?
I would think we would just do it to ours, because I think we are the Northampton. We have to keep it geared toward just Northampton.
But do we do it just to our state rep, or do we also do it to the other people? I'm inclined to send it to the...
You mean like the Leo and all?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. But I mean, we wouldn't send it to like Eric Lesser or something like that, that's what I mean.
So I think that the thing we would add to the conversation is basically just saying we see this as a human rights issue.
Yeah.
I don't have any magic suggestions for the $3 million that would fix that problem.
So are you volunteering to write the letter?
I could with somebody else.
Because we want to send it before the next meeting, I'm assuming.
I don't think I should do it. I should definitely, maybe I could do it with you.
Yeah, I was thinking that it would be good to have a proposal in place for next meeting.
Oh, so you think we can wait till the next meeting?
I think it will.
I mean, if the date already passed, we can try and get in there if they still haven't. But so if we wait a whole month.
Yeah, it's so sooner as possible.
The mayor is the head of the advisory board?
Yes.
The transportation advisory board or the PVTA?
The PVTA advisory board.
I mean, we're talking about the 25th of April.
Yeah. I mean, I think it would be better to be quicker about it, to do it between the meeting and send it out. Have a subcommittee of people who can write it and everybody else empower them to do it and then send it out on behalf. And I think we should send it to those people plus the mayor.
Yeah. Because he happens to be the head of this advisory committee.
If I was going to do it, I'd want to do it pretty soon. So I'm going to go away for a few days again.
I feel like there's a proposal shipping itself.
So, yeah, so moved.
Okay. Is there a second?
Okay. Who seconded it?
Booker.
It was
Commissioner Bush. Because I learned to write on that.
It's for posterity. All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so we'll authorize. Do we authorize Lena to find out this information? And are you drafting a letter?
Yes, but I'd like somebody. I don't know.
So the subcommittee of...
Yeah, so who's the...
I wouldn't mind. I don't mind looking at it. I just can't stick on writing it, but I can...
Yeah, I mean, I'll be able to look at it.
Okay. Is that okay?
That's terrific.
I'm going to send you the link to this article because it has like actual PVTA documents with information and stuff that might be useful.
Thank you.
Yeah, I forgot they have a pretty good website, don't they? Is that the PVTA?
No, it's MassLive.
Oh.
Thanks, Bella.
And do we want to put it in the newspaper just for public awareness that the Human Rights Commission has spoken up about it and does feel strongly about it?
Wait, say that again?
So, like, putting in the newspaper just because I know not a lot of people, you know, read the minutes or know what we're working on. So I think doing that shows people that the Human Rights Commission did have an opinion about it and did have something to say about it, because otherwise they wouldn't know that we felt any way or probably
that's a really good idea.
Voiced our opinion in any way.
I'm sure you think people don't read our minutes, but a little upset.
Thank you. So under new business, I have a couple of things. We have the pledge posters and pledge forms out at Forbes Library at A to Z. And was there somewhere else? Oh, the mayor's office. I will collect those because I'll be there tomorrow for a meeting. But could somebody collect the Forbes Library? You said you could collect
the Forbes Library.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Or otherwise I couldn't come to A to Z.
I don't mind. You're writing the letter, so I can do A to Z.
They might still be on the bulletin board. The owner is Andre. Didn't we put them other places though? Does anybody remember? I feel like
I know Broadside asked for them. Did Broadside actually get them?
I don't know
what's that called.
But I think maybe Chris. Oh, they're at the UU. I'll get the UU ones. But I think Chris brought them to Lilly Library.
Oh,
so.
Okay. I'll email her separately.
Okay. So she can get them at Lilly.
Okay.
I'll get the UU ones, and I have some at the DA's office, so I'll bring them.
Great.
So we can all bring them to the next meeting.
We'll bring them to the next meeting and have a final or a tally, but up to the moment, it doesn't have to be final. But we'll have a sense of how many we got.
Mm-hmm.
I just am bring it up as a, it's not in Northampton, but if you followed the news in Springfield, there's a church that has given sanctuary to
an
undocumented person, and the mayor of Springfield is trying everything in his power to exactly, to not let the church have to have capacity. I find it appalling, but I'm not sure we have a role.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it's unbelievable, but I don't know that it's our place as this commission.
Sorry, so what exactly happened?
So a congregation in Springfield has taken in an undocumented
family. Oh, okay.
And the mayor has directed his health department to make an inspection of the building to make sure that he's trying. He stated that Springfield is not a sanctuary city, and that the building is not coded for residential use.
And to withdraw their tax exempt status. Yeah, that was one of his directives to do that, but his last sentence was, thank you and God bless, which I thought was incredibly ironic, but.
Yeah. Yes, to withdraw their tax exempt status would be a long
battle. It's mind-boggling that he would even say that, because he really can't do it, but it was just nasty. I mean.
But the issue of if they haven't set up the building to meet certain codes, that's actual.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Along with hundreds of other buildings in Springfield that he hasn't seemed to concerned about.
Yeah.
You know, but that's the problem. That's the hypocrisy of it. But anyway.
Yeah. I think as a Northampton Human Rights Commission, I'm not sure there's much we can do, though I guess as individuals.
Does anyone know if Springfield has a Human Rights Commission?
I'm sorry?
Does Springfield have a Human Rights Commission?
Not to my knowledge.
Thank you. So we might be able to contact them.
I don't see anything.
Wouldn't surprise me.
So basically we're thinking it's not appropriate to reach out to this
city of Northfield, Springfield. That's what we're thinking for minutes purposes.
I don't see how we can. I don't know what, under what guise, with what.
Well, with the end of the guise of like, we represent, you know, we believe in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and we think that, whatever.
Yes, but would it, I mean, is it?
So that's actually sort of the second question. One of the questions is, what, from our prior discussions, what can we do in terms of writing to the state and things like that about PBTA decision making? And this is just sort of our scope. And it's the same issue about, can we write to Springfield as the Northampton Human Rights Commission or not? I don't know what the...
Yeah, I think the difference is though, we're writing the state and everything about something that's affecting Northampton.
Right, that's true.
Right.
And this is unfortunately not specifically affecting Northampton. As horrendous as it is, and as wrong as it is, I think our scope is the city.
I don't remember where the person was living prior to going.
It's been there a while, I think.
No, they've been in the area for 17 years.
Right.
But like, were they living in Springfield, or was the person living in Springfield? Yeah, I asked a different question. Mm-hmm. Did you do the thing with the
CDBG?
Yeah.
Yes.
Is there anything?
Yes. We actually had to cancel the first day because there's snow, so tomorrow's the last sessions we scheduled. It was fascinating to look through all of the applications for community development block grants. I actually asked Peg Keller, who's our administrator in the city, ahead of time, if undocumented individuals and families can be eligible for services provided by CDBG grants. That was a question I had about a number of the projects. And as long as the grants are not going to a government entity, they can be, and they are serving. Many of these grantees are serving immigrants and undocumented people. There's an awful lot of good work going on. I have to say, the most bang for the buck, I think, is the folks who run the Mana Soup Kitchen. Mm-hmm. They do so much with so little. You know, they do really remarkable. Remarkable. Yeah. So. Any other like more specific questions?
Were there any new programs seeking money?
I don't think there were any new ones. And the city doesn't know yet, or hadn't known as of last week, what their final CDBG number was going to be. Mm-hmm. So we're not sure if they can all be funded.
So you guys just approved it contingent on the money?
It's not approved. We just listened to the applicants came in, and we asked them questions based on the application that they submitted. And after the meeting tomorrow, we'll have deliberations about what can be funded.
Do you have any need to do brainstorming with us about that, or you know what you want to do?
I think we're going to be in a position where all of the fundies, all of the grantees will be able to receive some funding at least. There was one program that the only questionable program that for me was one that delivers hot meals to elders in the community. They home deliver, I think it's 200 meals a week or something like that. But
it's through a federal program that is not needs-based, so it's not financial needs-based. So they can, they will deliver, home deliver a meal to someone, even if they could afford to have somebody else cook for them.
Is this Meals on Wheels?
It's from, it's through Highland Valley.
Yeah, I think it's Meals on Wheels, which is a long-standing program for a lot of countries.
But this is like the specific slice of the piece that they do. So they have people, the result is they have people on the waiting list who are poor, but they have to be, on the waiting list because there are others who may have the financial resources to get their meals in another way, but they can't cook themselves. The only criteria is that you can't cook for yourself.
Is special because they not only deliver meals, there's also a social component. There's an expectation that the person hangs out and chooses, to use clinical words, so it's not just the delivery of the meal, there's a checking in that's part of it too.
But I wonder if they ask for donations, because I mean, I think it's a really important thing for people. It helps some people stay in their homes longer. It's a simple thing that helps them stay in their homes.
Yeah, that's true.
And that's not just about, like, what
I mean, the thing is, it's not financially needs-based. Mm-hmm. It's, do you need this kind of service? And whether you can pay for it or not, I mean, is not part of it.
Yeah. And the reality is, if you're 91, who are you going to know to pay for your money?
Yeah, right.
I mean, it's...
Right.
And you may not be willing to, even though strictly speaking you could. And or if your mind doesn't allow it, you might, you know, might get some advantages to. But it's also awful that there'll be grenade and can't get it.
I think that's the bigger struggle is, yes, can we just get rid of the waiting list and just...
How many people do they have in that room?
I'm not sure.
I just have one little announcement from Chris. Chris sent me a text and asked me to let you all know about this. It's a, she took a picture of this thing. Bystander training workshops, different bystander trainings, not by that Quabbin mediation. Two workshops, I think it looks like two workshops this weekend. One is Saturday and it's, Saturday at the Northampton Center for the Arts. No, on Holly Street.
Yeah.
And it's about interrupting sexual harassment, the Saturday one. And the Sunday one is interrupting racism. So if anybody wants me, I could text you this. Anybody? Okay. 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 Bye, Booker.
The only other thing I had on my new business list was when I was talking to the Quabbin mediation people, they mentioned that the Human Rights Commission in the town of Lexington had done a bystander training. They hosted it, and that's something that they do on a recurring basis, which led me to look up the town of Lexington's Human Rights Commission, and they've got it going on.
Yeah.
Take a look at their pages.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was very exciting to think of the possibilities. And it sent me down another rabbit hole in trying to find out if there is a state organization or coalition of community human rights commissions that we could be, you know, like Greenfield came to us. And I haven't been able to find one that exists yet. Mm-hmm. But gosh, it would be nice to have.
Mm-hmm. I did see this.
Maybe communication and response from a coalition of the commissions, I think would be pretty exciting. Mm-hmm. I just think it would be exciting if there were a coalition of human rights commissions and we could have collaborative responses.
Yeah, right. That would be
statewide issues.
Yeah.
So I'm going to keep searching for that.
So you recommend that we look at the
County of Lexington Human Rights Commission. Yeah, they seem very, very active. And I might just reach out to their contact person to find out about their bystander training so they
okay.
Response to that.
Okay.
It wasn't clear to me who's putting these on. This was
I just had one other thing that I wanted to mention is that Pride March.
Mm-hmm.
That's May. That's May 5th. So that's like less than a week after, a little over a week after our April meeting.
Mm. Yeah, we marched together. It was just you, the three of us.
The three of us, whatever. But I marched my company.
Oh, okay.
But if the company's not marching or something, would we march with the city then?
Yes, that's what we did. Yes.
Okay, we
marched
did that.
With the city council and the mayor.
You have a t-shirt.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a t-shirt.
I will let it march.
Yes. You get the gold star.
Funny, I didn't even think about it.
Yeah.
That's shame on me. You know.
Well, I think you weren't at the last meeting. Somebody
yeah.
mentioned it at the last meeting.
Yeah.
And I have no excuse because I forgot it anyway.
So in the minutes of putting, should we march together? So can we talk about that next time?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I mean, it's earlier. I just thought I'd throw it out because it'll be pretty quick. But yeah.
Okay.
The only other, are you going to be redoing these then?
Yeah, to fix the NA. Yeah.
Okay. These are awesome. The only question I would have, and it's minor now, but I love this, but it's all women.
Yeah, that's one thing I noticed as well.
Yeah.
The reason is because I use...
Welcome to our world, Joe.
Yeah, as I'm sitting here.
I'm affiliated with this website where I can get... I pay a monthly fee and then I can get stock photos that I don't have to pay copyright and stuff for. So when I put that in, that one was the only one. Otherwise, it was all Army veterans. And that didn't feel... So then I thought that one might be more appropriate, but I'll try and see if I can find another one or I'll create a silhouette and put that in.
Yeah, it'd just be nice to have a little...
Yeah, I noticed that as well.
I mean, can we just use our...
Oh, true. I thought about that too. I was going to ask you, but then it was so last minute. But
yeah.
If you have it in a file, then I can just put that
That'd
in there.
That'd be great.
Yeah, that would be perfect. I'll write that down so that I don't think any before.
But I didn't want it to take anything away from this because I think it's wonderful.
Beautiful.
It's
Thank
absolutely
you.
Wonderful.
I really also appreciate it. You just did it.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Really good.
Thought it might be a good way to get people to
Yes. Yeah, which we did
come to the meetings or something.
Yeah.
I could get some color printing if that helps.
That'd be awesome. Yeah.
Like if you send me the, I can make copies.
That'd be super helpful. Yeah. Thank you.
Did you do these at the
pocket? I ended up printing them at my house because I called like Paradise and then the Amherst one, and it was way too expensive. So I just it was easier to just buy ink and do it at home. But yeah, so having that would be amazing.
Can you contribute to me?
I think it was like $13. It wasn't a big deal for. The first batch that I did, yeah, it wasn't like too much out of pocket. I didn't mind at all. Yeah, when I talked to like Paradise, it was like going to be several hundred dollars. So I was like, oh, I can't pay that out of pocket.
Yeah.
But $13, I don't mind at all.
Dedicated, are you?
Yeah.
Yeah, because it would be good to. I'm just looking at which specific things we're asking folks to follow up on. If these will still be. Pertinent or relevant for the Pride March.
Mm-hmm.
And the Pride March
yeah,
well.
Definitely. And I'm happy to make new ones if we wanted to have like something that was more relevant to the Pride March.
Well, the only thing about this is, without it having the context of the march, what's next, here's what you can do.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's without context.
Yeah, when it's not at the march, yeah.
But not at the, you know, the...
The one before.
Right.
Exactly, yeah.
So either it has to have different headline or it could be a generic thing about what issues are important to you and this is what you do.
Yeah.
Even if you had the headline of just saying become active.
Right, but then it would, you'd have to take out those specific bills.
Exactly, because then it would have to be more of,
But if this was a template that we could use.
The template's great, though, to, you know, fill it in.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
We'll never run out of things.
That's true.
So I thought the things that you, the things like the Dickey Amendment, I mean, they're such key things.
Yes. I contacted the Boston March of Our Lives crew and talked to them and got some ideas from them, so it wasn't all from me, but I helped them and communicated with them, right, things to add,
That is really great. Can I just have one little announcement? Does anybody want a Sojourner Truth School schedule?
A what, I'm sorry?
So Sojourner Truth School, it's all free classes, by different trainers in churches in Hampshire, Franklin, and Hampden County. And it's all about building a movement and building movement skills for social justice, so.
I looked at them online, but I'll take it to you.
And one of the green one is just winding up, but this one is the one for the summer. And then there's also this, which is an event, Wisdom Analysis Inspiration from Seasoned Organizers at the Edwards Church on May 18th with local organizers.
Oh, this is January, February, March.
Oh, so I gave you the wrong one. Oh, so it's the, I got the.
I think that's lost.
Oh, okay. I do have another one I can get to.
Yeah.
It's online.
It's online. It is online.
Oh, if it's online, then I'll look at it. Okay. Yeah.
But they're really good classes, and they're all free. Anyway, if anybody wants to look at it.
For the for the meeting for April 3rd, do you guys want me to change the title, the headline, something different? If so, what do you think would be appropriate?
I think for April 3rd. I mean, all these things
still relevant,
aren't they?
The only thing is maybe you could say what's next to stop gun violence, or just something that, like, kind of lets people know what these